Clarity is vital to the progress of a local church community. When a church has had various people in leadership throughout the years with differing focuses, it can be confusing to a congregation what's most important and where we're going. Different cultural values and styles are going to change every time a lead pastor or a significant elder change happens. Implementing that change can be really tricky because you want to both honor the past and you want to think about what's been accomplished while you're implementing fresh, focused direction in a strategic way to help the church move forward. Four things that are guaranteed to happen when you have a lead pastor change at a church is that within the first 5 years, the culture of the staff team will need to be clarified and rebuilt. The financial systems and stability will need to be assessed and reevaluated. The systems that are non-existent or that just aren't working need to be fixed. And your reputation in the community may need to be addressed. This is a culture shift to create clarity and alignment so that the church can move forward together for the long haul. A church culture shift is necessary when dysfunctional systems and values have been allowed to exist. The elders and the lead pastor work together to bring clarity and alignment incrementally, because if we just change everything at once, there would be a mass chaos and confusion. Change always creates a little bit of that, but if it's done incrementally, then it's manageable as the overall culture shift is happening. We have walked through a few big shifts at BCC, most notably our name change and the expectations of our staff roles. Our name change was something that the elders and I worked on for over 2 years to discern God's will and timing in this. We believed the clarity was vital to our vision and mission, even though we knew it would be tough for some people. We very much covered this in prayer and in discussion. Staff culture has only become more aligned and more unified with our ministry philosophy and our staff values. We have worked really hard to become a team of people who have differing gifts, differing personalities, but we all share in the responsibility of equipping the church for ministry. We have also hired with defining this culture in mind. There was a time when we made more public hires and we involved the congregation more, and we've shifted away from those practices because we don't want to create a celebrity culture within the church staff of BCC, or to create some unhealthy expectancy that all staff issues would be concerns of someone who attends our church. We will continually communicate big changes as the elders deem appropriate, but shifting away from the staff being a bigger focus in the church is necessary for us to see the entire church in a healthy light. So that means staff hires are simply just co-laborers with the rest of the church body. They just have different responsibilities. They have different leadership roles that require that they're compensated for their time. I regularly have shared that I believe BCC is not Derek's church, or it's not about the lead pastor, it's not about any particular staff person, past or present. Staff members are simply a part of the body, and they are serving with the congregation, not for the congregation. There's a significant difference in those two attitudes towards church staff, because church staff do not work for the people in the church, but rather they work with the people in the church. We are co-laborers in Christ with you. No one is deserving of extra special attention simply because they're a pastor or a leader, because humility is key with every staff role at BCC. If we stop having humility and teachability, we become prideful and we disqualify ourselves from leadership roles. Navigating this type of change requires humility and trust from our congregation and patience and good communication from the leadership. We don't always get that right on both ends of the spectrum. However, if we remind ourselves of God's purpose, trust in God's leading, and if we remain humble, God will show His approval of what we are doing by the fruit that it produces for the glory of God. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time He may exalt you.